This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
See you live off the record with Zhivargo Laing is brought to you by Burger King, the Cleveland Clinic, Dunkin' Donuts, ESC Distributors Limited, Grand Bahama News, Prince Masters, RF Banking Trust, and Royal Star Assurance.
And good afternoon, good day. This is Z Live on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Yes, this Pearly in the house one more day, filling in for my good buddy and friend, Zhivargo Laing, as we continue to keep him in our prayers on his loss of his mother, Senator MCM Naomi Seymour. May she rest in peace and rise in glory. How's everybody doing? How's the day going? It's another hot day. You think you can start cooling down soon? It's really, really hot out there, but it's a lot better than it was in July, I guess. So what's happening today? Let's take a quick look. Oh, if you're going to get to me today, we're going to talk some things and some things on my mind that I'm really concerned about, and I want to get your views on it, get your input on it. So you can get me at 323-6232. That's 323-6232. 325-4316. 325-4316. 325-4259, 325-4259, 242, toll free, 242-300-5720. And you can text me on the text line powered by BTC 422-GR96. That's 422-4796. Ah, boy, it's an interesting day. Some interesting things in the papers. I had an opportunity to watch the House of Assembly. I'm going to bring that up and get your views on that. Too much duplicity in this country. But anyway, we can get to that in a second. Let's get into what's on the headlines. Rapist sentenced to 9 years in prison. Man who carried out a string of violent crimes take plea deal. Davil knocks down F&M criticism on site for new hospital. Former CEO of FTX sister firm Alameda Research sentenced to 2 years. And basic bank accounting being embraced by all BOSAs. And let's take a quick look at what's going on in the business section. Central Bank mulling measures to stop merchants overcharging on card payments. Roll, if the price is $2, it's $2 regardless of how the payment is made. Bo, it's a matter of educating the consumer to say when you see it and to report it. Attorney General's office wins Privy Council appeal against Rudy King. Role, reforms relationship needs to attract popular payment platform, SBDC to focus on male entrepreneurs with men in business, and Britannia acquires Deltek line of business. That's interesting. That's very, very interesting. So people, the front page of The Guardian knocked me off my feet this morning. Well, not The Guardian, but the story. Let's get that right. The story. This brother, this young man, was given 9 years. He struck a plea deal with the prosecution, I guess, with the courts, and got 9 years for a bunch of stuff he did. Now, I understand you're trying to, you know, you don't want to waste the court's time, and you could be doing some other things, and you get this out of the way quickly. But this dude did 4 counts of robbery, housebreaking and robbery, attempted rape, steal a car, attempted rape again, robbed a couple of places. Come on, man, 9 years? But while he got this for that, you know, a couple of years for this, a couple of years for that, it was served concurrently, if I'm saying it correctly, and not consecutively. So the man does something, should put him in jail for 100 million years, based on 99 years based on my text to say. But he got 9 years. Is that fair? Is that justice? Is that something that that grand 80-something-year-old grandmother who was raped? 80-something grandmother. You think you can rape my grammy and get away with that like that? You think that's going to happen? But we can talk about that in a little bit. We do have our guests in today. Remember, today is Digital Banking Week. This week is Digital Banking Week. And we have our good friends in from Scotiabank. So we're going to talk to them for a few minutes. And when we get back, think, mull on what I said. Mull on that. Mull on also that the spy bill, or the National Crime Intelligence Agency bill, was being debated today. Some amendments are being made. And some things I see happen, I question, and when it was brought by the Minister administration in 2019, the then leader of the opposition, who's now prime minister, called some stuff in that unconstitutional. Fine, okay, I can live with that. You bring the bill back today, but you don't change the things you find unconstitutional. I have a concern about that. But we'll talk about all that in a few minutes, but we can talk to our friends at Scotiabank. Who do I have with me today from Scotiabank? Are they there?
There is someone here. I'm not from Scotiabank.
Where are you from?
Bank of the Bahamas.
You're actually from the bank that I bank with. Okay.
The Bank of the Bahamas.
The Bank of the Bahamas, yes.
Let's get that together.
Owned by the Bahamian people.
Absolutely.
And ran by Bahamian people.
Absolutely. All the way through.
How you doing?
Wonderful. Thank you for asking.
And who am I have the pleasure of speaking with today?
My name is Rochelle Thompson-Walker, and I'm the assistant manager for the marketing department at Bank of the Bahamas.
You got a good last name, Thompson. I like that.
You understand? I love it. So,
is there any reason why you didn't drop it? I figured you said Thompson Walking?
Walker.
Walker. That's your marriage name.
Yes.
You like my ex-wife. She keep her first name too with my name. Okay.
I went my whole life with my name. All of my major accomplishments.
That's your name. You only borrowed that X when this one is yours.
Say you said the right thing. Right terminology, borrow. Return at will.
Mr. Walker could come looking for me to tell me how I put him in problems.
Oh, I already returned that.
Oh, I got you.
You couldn't be trouble all
the time. Can we talk banking?
You understand? Listen, so as you prefaced our conversation, this is Digital Week.
Yes.
And we have partnered with the Central Bank of the Bahamas and all of the other retail banking institutions here in country to make sure that we want to let the public know that, you know, the future of payment is digital.
Okay.
And we want everyone to understand that, never mind that we're one of the young guys on the block and we don't have the 50 and 60, 70 years under our belt, but we're trying to keep up with everybody, and we've gone digital as well.
Super.
Bank of the Bahamas is not to be left behind, and we are to make sure that all of our clients are also able to take advantage of all that is happening in the world of digitized banking.
Excellent.
So what exactly is the Live Digital Week? It's a week of festivities which is aimed to promote and raise the visibility of digital payment solutions available in the Bahamas. And one of the biggest aims of the week, as I mentioned, is to foster awareness and educate the public about the benefits and importance of adopting digital payment systems. So that is our main purpose for hosting Digital Weeks. You know, bit by bit, the Central Bank has been speaking about the possibility of eventually doing away with the paper, the checks in particular. And this is a part of making sure that everyone gets up to speed with what is happening. And as I mentioned, Bank of the Bahamas is right there in the trenches with everybody. You know, we have changed our proprietary ATM card now. So we now have a BOB Visa debit card.
Super.
So all your money is available to you 24/7. You don't have to worry. I don't have access here or there. You can shop 24/7 from the comfort of your home. We have an updated platform here, our online banking platform, and we do our service at the speed of light. You know, you can have immediate transfers from account to account. You can set up all of your bill payments. You can do your shopping as you normally would. Just live your life and save all of that time that you would have spent standing on a bank line somewhere. We're hoping to eliminate that as much as possible by making sure that our digital processes are updated and in tune with what is happening in the market. In fact, we've even advanced in terms of our merchant services option, because a lot of people want to be able to take digital payment on their platforms for their online businesses or just for their mobile businesses. You know, you have the hair braiders and your makeup artists, taxi drivers. We've got those handheld merchant service devices as well.
Super.
So people have Apple Pay and Google Pay and all of this. You can do that through Bank of the Bahamas as a part of our merchant services platform. So when I say we have really been in the trenches and bringing this digitization alive and making it accessible to everybody, that's exactly what we have been doing.
Okay, super. So, yeah, I had some of your other friends on early in the week. That's why I'm kind of, you know.
And yes.
They talked about, so you're celebrating the same days like Monday and Tuesday was debit card, credit card, bank. Today is which day now? What's celebrating?
Well, what we did, we didn't break up the days. Every day was all the products.
I got
so
you.
So JFK was on Monday, and then we were at our Carmichael yesterday, where we spoke about everything. Today we're at Village Road. Tomorrow we'll be at our Shirley Street location. And one of the things, we just want to encourage people who did not pick up their BOB Visa debit card. Listen. Go get them, because we will be cutting off the old proprietary gold card very shortly.
So
we want to go ahead.
Is the card a tap or a swipe or both?
Listen, both tap and go. This is EMV chip technology
using. So I have a texter asks me, hey, good afternoon. Question for your guest. Is there a limit to how much can tap for payment?
Not particularly. Whatever is on your account is what's available. The difference is, There are some limits. For example, if it's under $50, you probably won't have to put in your PIN. But over that, to verify that it's you and not a fraudulent transaction, you have to insert certain details into the processing machine for the payment to go through.
So if I, not that I have now, so don't believe I have this kind of money. If I have like, say, 50 grand on my account and I won't go buy a car for 30 grand, I could tap that and spend it in...
They will insert that. You can use it from the card, though, because it's coming directly off of your account.
I got you.
Then you would put in your code for us to know that it's you. And even then, we will probably still call you back just to verify, is this you making this purchase?
And letting, you know, anybody that thinking, I know Pearlie don't have that kind of money in this guy. This is used as an example. So I don't want anybody coming to tell me, take him to lunch tomorrow. Okay.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay, so how has the response been from your customers in reference to, I mean, to this... You know, I you hear people, I guess the older you get, we don't like change too much. So some of us still like to go in the bank. Ladies often say she don't have no bank book no more. So people don't understand that we're changing and evolving. So,
well, for some of the older folks, going to the bank is actually an outing. You know, they see that as a, this is my day to go and meet my friends and have a bit of a chit chat and a little sip of coffee and just shoot the breeze. So not all the time they're at the bank. They're actually doing some banking. They're actually just here
networking,
having conversations with their colleagues and friends.
Yes.
But for the most part, their grandchildren and children are actually helping them to become automated on the system, showing them how to use the online banking, showing them how to make their utility payments so they don't have to have someone come take me down to BPL or whatever. They sit home and do it. They're using their tablets and their phones to do everything that they may have been doing by hopping in the car. So,
I love it. I don't have to. One time ago, I just have to go into BPL at the time, BEC. Then you got to go to BTC. Then you got to go to Cable Bahamas. Now all I do is sit down and in 5 minutes, I pay my light bill, my cable bill, my water bill.
But you know something? On the BOB online banking platform, you can set that up to be a recurring payment so that whatever the amount is, you set an amount in your system.
Uh-huh.
So it'll be automated and come out automatically. And you have the ability to set that frequency up on your own from our online banking platform.
Wonderful.
When I tell you, we've been doing some great things at Bank of the Bahamas. We might be small, but we're powerful, and we're doing.
I so like you. So, do you offer credit cards as well? A prepaid credit cards, postpaid credit cards. Do you offer anything like that?
Both we do. We have our regular credit card and we have our prepaid cards. We suggest a prepaid card, particularly for persons who have their young ones going off to school. And this is your way to teach them to be a little bit more frugal and fiscally prudent with organizing their funds. So you load their prepaid card with whatever it is, and they have to manage it for that period of time until you make another deposit. So it helps them with their financial intelligence. Use the money wisely. And then you just can keep tapping it up as you go. And so that allows them to use the services of a credit card without a credit card bill. Because if you spend all on it, then there's no money left.
I wish you all was doing this when my children was in college. I didn't have to worry about this. I could have been sending, instead of having to send a pile, you could have said, okay, you need this, you do that. But
and our prepaid card can take a maximum of $10,000. Now, you're not going to give your college child $10,000 on the card one go. But you have the ability to load that amount. So even if you had to pay for a semester or something, you can load that much on a card and either take care of room and board or something like that, and then just load it up again and not worry about traveling with loads of cash or waiting for a wire transfer to go through. You walk with it on your card. We do offer our regular credit card services as well. We have our, as well as a gold card as well. We do that as well. So okay. We have all of that.
And it's all Visa-based?
Yes. Yes, we are.
Okay. So we have a caller. Let's see what our caller has to say. So don't go nowhere, because this is probably a question for you. Caller, you on there. How you doing?
Hey, good day, Pearly. Hey, this is Pearly L.
Good afternoon, Pearly L. How you doing?
Fine, thank you.
What's up?
Good day to your guest. I have a question. Because I don't like the online thingy as much. Because I was actually locked out of my online thing for a while. Because it asked me some silly questions when I set it up. And I don't even remember what the answers was.
AJ, anyway. Nothing but a number. Oh, sorry, exactly. sorry.
But so my question is this. With the bouncing back and forth Wi-Fi that we have, the on and off electricity that we have, why is it that central banks still trying to move to cashless, when we know that in this country will come a day when you need to push it in your pocket and pull a dollar out?
Well, to be honest, while I do not have the answer for a question that is directly sent addressed to the central bank,
mm-hmm.
I can only answer you from Bank of the Bahamas' standpoint. Mm-hmm. That would be somebody else would have to take that on. But I cannot answer it. I don't know what their logic is. But as far as we know that the entire world is changing the way we process and the way we do business, and the way people accept payment for their goods and services is changing rapidly. So we're trying to keep up to date with what is happening to make sure that our clients aren't left in behind, and you're walking around with loads of paper money and nobody wants to accept it from you, because we do have merchants who at this point do not even want to take cash.
I do understand that, but do you know when I travel to the US, I have almost everybody accepting, they give me an option, cash or card. So I don't understand what's the rush for the cashless, when even in America, because they want you to have that option. I would like to have that option. I wouldn't want to just go one way, because we don't know what will happen. Then the cash will probably be needed.
Brilliant. I hear your point, and while most businesses in the States will ask you cash or card, probably 70% of the people using card nowadays. And times are changing, times are changing. People sticking gun in your face, robbing you and stuff like that. So,
no, I understand that.
I guess it's more for security purposes as well.
Yes. I don't like to walk around with too much cash on me either, but I just would like to know that the option is there.
The option is there for most companies.
The option is there, but most companies, as he mentioned, would prefer if you use a card platform to pay your bills, so then it's a twofold thing. You're safe. They're safe. Their staff is safe. They don't have to worry about all this extra. You have to get security to do this, and
I'm a truck
all runner. Of this money have to be counted. So it's a lot of variables in there. So it boils down to mostly being a safety net.
The key word to this, Pearly L, is called change. And sometimes we do buck change. And I understand your point, because Pearly like to travel. I keep at least $10, $15 in my pocket at all times, because you never know when.
Right.
You go to a little convenience store, they don't have the machine there yet, or you buy one soda.
You to use your card.
That was the next question I'm coming to, because I saw the central bank, the governor of the central bank said early in the article I read today that if the bill is $2, the bill's supposed to be $2, and people need to report when companies try to charge you for using your debit card. Madam.
The thing with that part is, you know, that's a part of their contract with the with Visa in general. They're not supposed to add on anything. If it's two, it's two. And the, when they sign up to be a merchant accepting Visa payments, they agree that they will bill the customer exactly whatever the item is. Yeah. So they are actually those that do extra. They're in breach of their own.
They're actually breaking the law. And so you read the report. So if somebody goes to you and says, the item is $2, but if you can charge your card, that's make it three. That's against the law. You can report them to the cops.
Okay, all right. We're glad to know that.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much.
All right. We got a couple more callers, Madam Thompson Walker.
Yes. You can call me Rochelle.
Rochelle. I just don't. I have to get your permission, you know. Why? I am usually smooth around women. I don't know why I'm fumbling right now, you know.
Hey.
Carly, you on there. How you doing?
The mojo.
Carly, you on there. How you doing? I guess that caller got impatient. Y'all can't be impatient with me. Y'all, I keep telling y'all, like, wordy. Carly, you on there. How you doing?
Yeah, gracious, you're pretty.
How you doing, brother?
I have a question for your guests, right?
Okay.
They give very good service to BOB. I really appreciate that. But
you.
Could your guest do something with the wire transfer section on the online banking, right, to make it a little easier for customers? Because it's not the easiest thing in the world to operate.
Okay. Are you on the new platform or the old platform?
Okay, that's a good question. I'm not familiar with which one I'm on, but it's not the easiest thing in the world to use because I normally purchase cards from IEA. So I need to send funds from my account to IEA.
We know that the newer platform is a little easier to maneuver as opposed to the older. So if you're on the one that says Express, you're on the old platform.
Oh, okay, I use the Express one. It's like almost like a nightmare to use.
That is the old platform. So we need to make sure that you are now migrated to the new platform so that you can have a lot easier and a smoother.
Which one is the new platform?
So how does he migrate to the new platform? Does he have to call into his bank or can he do something? Does he have to go in or something he can just do on himself?
We can send us an email at bob.info@bankbahamas.bs.
bob.info@bankbahamas.bs.
Yes.
You got that, caller?
Yes. That's all I have to say.
Okay. So, caller, so what you do is email them and tell them that you want to move from the Express platform to the new platform, and then they'll guide you.
Okay. Yes. Appreciate it.
Thanks for calling.
Thank you.
One more text. One more caller. Caller, go. Are you on the air?
Yes. Good afternoon to you and your guests.
How you doing?
My concern with this cashless thing is, it's the small man who is going to be hurt by this more than anything else. Okay, do you charge each time they use the card, ma'am?
Yes, we do.
Whatever. Okay, now.
There's a processing fee.
Let's say the small man who's getting paid $275, $300. When he leaves, he gets paid at work. He goes, he has to pay the lunch lady. Then, if he wants to go and buy groceries in the food store, he has to pay that. He has to tap that. Then if he wants to buy other little things for the house, he has to pay that. So the charges, I mean, a lot of his money is going to be eaten up by charges, what he needs.
Well, here's the thing to that.
And with his cash, it would go a little further.
Not if he's continuously going to the ATM and making a withdrawal. Each time he makes a withdrawal, he's got to pay a fee, whereas he can just use his card, and it's the same fee. It's still a fee.
But, yes.
Whether you're taking it out of the ATM, you're not going to take out $500 one time, especially if you don't have to spend it all right now.
Pardon? Cash, and he don't go to the ATM.
So how do you get the cash?
How do we get the cash? Even if he goes over the counter?
The boss man is going to pay him in cash.
You're really fixing you're really fixing the story up good now. See,
yeah,
you
got, listen, let's take for instance, I have a gardener.
Okay.
You think I am gonna go to the bank or deposit this money in the bank? I'm gonna pay him cash.
Yeah, but that gardener probably how would I phrase this?
That's what
Then he's not going to be paying anything to use the card because he's using the cash you gave him.
If you're paying him by cash, he ain't using the card, period. If you're not going to go to the bank to give him money, he ain't going to the bank to deposit that money. He just going to spend things. So that's a mute point.
I'm talking about them when they go cashless.
Well,
they like us to go cashless. The lady said, she would like to have the use of both of them.
Yeah, and while the banks and while banks and businesses will push as many people to go cashless, you're still gonna have pretty much have the option to spend cash if you want to, because there are gonna be one or two people to do that. It's just a lot more convenient, safer to go through your card than to be traveling with a bunch of cash in your pocket. That's all the point.
What you call it, a bunch of cash? Nobody's gonna walk around with $400 or $500 in their pocket.
Ah, you helping my argument out right here then.
Exactly.
Yeah. So if I got $400 in my pocket, I ain't too concerned about that. Because you sound like people walking around with thousands of dollars in their pocket.
Yeah, I didn't say that. But listen, fellas, you think the fellas look at you and think you got $1,000 if he come to hit you, or you, it don't matter what you got, he taking it.
Yeah, but the percentage of robberies are far outweigh what they're trying to do. People are not, you might have one or two robberies a night.
You are helping my argument so good. I like this.
You're talking about
400,000
people.
Uh-huh.
So, what?
Out of that 400,000 people, what percentage do you think getting paid cash to do gardening? 400, if that many?
You got to see, that's another thing we don't even know, because we don't know who in the country.
See, now you're getting you're taking me to a whole different road. You carrying me to a whole different place right now. Let me read it. But, you know, I understand what he's trying to say, but the point is, if I'm a person not going to go and deposit for my gardener to his bank account, and I paying him cash, he ain't going, if I give him the money Friday, then you think what bank he going to do to deposit that money?
Unless he's planning on doing some online shopping, he's keeping that in his pocket, he's going to spend that right there.
Okay, so we're going to wrap up, but just before we wrap up, I'm going to read a couple of texts and then get you to make your final comments with me. Good afternoon, Pearly. Nice to hear B.O.B. I remember when B.O.B. introduced the prepaid Visa pay-as-you-go. They're always doing great stuff.
Good afternoon,
but this is the thing. They don't charge extra for using the credit card. They give you a discount for not using it. Some people may do that. It says, the future of payment is digital. According to who? Foreign entities or masters? This is all leading to control of the person and their spending and monitor people. Actually, businesses lose money because of bank fees when customers pay using credit card. So they are really would be preferred customers to pay cash. I don't know if I agree with that texter, but I hear your point. And it says, a good afternoon, Krish. I'm trying to add my BOB account to my Scotia Online Bank, but the bank address is saying Harold Road. Is that the right one to use?
Yes, that Harold Road would be what they can see, but it actually means JFK. That's our new location.
Super. Okay, so before I let you go, anything else you want to say to remind the customers, anything you want to wrap up on?
Yes, if you are having problems or if you need assistance with online banking, we invite all of our customers to contact our customer care unit. We are available from 7 a.m. to 11 p.m., 7 days a week, 365 days a year. They can reach us at 461-3510, or they can dial C-A-L-L-B-O-B, that's the numbers, 225-5262, or they can send us a message via WhatsApp at 557-5516. And someone is always available to answer. But we have a special for people who are using their BOB Visa debit card. It's called Dollars for Debit Cards. So every day this week so far, the first 36 customers, and we use 36 because this year we'll make our 36th anniversary.
Uh-huh.
The first 36 customers each day who walk into a BOB location with proof of using their Visa debit card to make a purchase, we're going to put $25 credit to your BOB account. So I think we've already met our numbers for today. So
I passed the branch by 9:15. I can be there tomorrow.
Well, tomorrow we'll be at Shirley Street,
okay. So, Rochelle, thank you so much for joining me.
It's my pleasure.
And it was great talking to you and great hearing the great things that happened at Bank of the Bahamas. Always want to hear Bahamian-owned things are doing great. Thank you so
Absolutely.
Much.
Absolutely. Thank you for having us.
Thank you for being here. This is Pearly filling in for Zhivargo Laing on Z-Live, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. When we get back, we can read these last set of texts and we can get into finding out what's going on and how you feel about some things happening in our good, good country. I'll be right back. You know that you're not alone. Holler if you feel like-
living with a neurological condition shouldn't define you. At Cleveland Clinic in Florida, we do whatever it takes to make life better today while discovering new treatments for a brighter tomorrow. From epilepsy management to specialized spine care and brain tumor surgery, we're delivering world-class neurology care for the day-to-day, for the days you live for every care in the world. Visit clevelandclinicflorida.org/Caribbean.
All those loans I had were so overwhelming. Fidelity's debt consolidation loan combined all my loan payments into one easy payment with a built-in savings plan that pays me unbeatable interest. It's time to make that move to Fidelity. Call 356-7764.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
I ain't mashed the car. The lady who ran into me mashed the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull out the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
Are you tired of the same old 5K runs? Want something more? Then get ready for the Chickchawney Challenge City Run on September 28th, starting at Crypto Wild. Test your strength, stamina, and spirit. It takes all of you to dodge, climb, conquer obstacles as you race through the heart of the city. Lace up and get to the Chickchawney Challenge City Run. Register now on our website, chickchawneychurn.com, or on our social media pages. Brought to you by Kalina, Island Yogurt, Advantage Insurance, Art of Graphics, Crypto Wild, and Guardian Radio 96.9.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.
And we're back. So good to be back here with y'all this afternoon. So great to have Madam Walker, Rochelle Thompson Walker on with us from Bank of the Bahamas. Thank you so much for joining us. I'll read this text. Hey, Pearly, when you see them make it cashless, when you go to the machine, no money can be there. I going to get all my money and put it under my... Somebody all creative in already now. You can put it under your belly. Okay, no problem. Call you on there. How you doing?
Doing.
Thank God for life. How you doing?
Yes, well, I saw you being on the other show anyhow.
Yeah, but every once in a while, my good friend Zhivargo will call on me to assist him.
Yeah,
you know,
don't
his...
go in with that woman with what she's saying.
Okay.
That's the new royal order. Bahamians should be able to have both.
Yes.
We as senior citizens have a right in this country because we build this country. You don't shove things down our throat and come on the air one day and say, we're going to do this and we're going to do that, and you must go along with that. I've been traveling to the United States for years. I go in Walmart. They have two lines, one for cash and one for digital. If they can do that in the big United States, what's the problem here?
No, I don't think it's a problem doing it here, you know.
Have a town meeting.
No,
but I'm trying.
No, I think what the bank is saying is, I think what the bank...
That role man to have a town meeting,
okay,
and people see what the payments, how they feel. We're tired of these things being put on us. That's the new world order.
So you want to stay with cash? You want to stay with cash? You want to hold your money in your hand and stay with cash?
No, I go with both.
Okay, and I think you can do both here.
I have a card right here. I was over there.
I went to
Village Road. I still never got my $400. So tell them stop talking foolishness, and I'm one of their clients. Tell them stop it.
Yes, ma'am.
Educate us. Have that for a while. Don't come one day and say we can push this on you.
No, I don't think they're doing that. Ma'am. Listen to me a minute now. I think that's the purpose of them coming on the radio shows is to promote, talk about it, and educate the listeners onto what direction they're moving in. There's nobody telling you that you only have to go cashless today, you know. They're saying that one day it'll come to that. Even in the States, it can come to that one day. It will come to that one day. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, and maybe not this year, or maybe not even next year. But it will come to that one day. But what they're is preparing people educating you on this, and you still have an option to pay by card, by credit card, debit card, or cash. Now, some companies are trying to push you from and saying they become cashless, and more of that is for safety reasons, you know, where the companies that do a lot of business and generate a whole lot of cash, they're more concerned about safety of their employees and their customers. So that might be the reason a lot of them push it. But I hear the argument of the New World Order, and however you want to look at that, that's fine. But I think you can still use both cash and cards, okay? That's interesting. You know, and let me read this text for you, and then we can get in some details. Any senior citizen reward programs with the card, little credit on utilities, pensioners could use the help and our pensions. Well, I don't know if the banks will give you a thing, but you know, if you go into certain companies, you get, I start flashing my driver's license, you show my age and get my 10% discount. So when you reach a certain age, 55 at some companies, 60 at some companies, 65 at others, they grant you a little discount. So the companies are now granting senior citizen companies. Banks are now allowing senior citizens to come a little earlier and give you a senior citizen line. But I learned one thing. If you go on a regular line and 10 people on that line, and you go on the senior citizen line, 4 people on that line, go on the line with 10 people, you can get served quicker. Caller, you on the air. How you doing?
Hello.
Hi.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, good day.
How you doing? Listen to your phone now. Listen to your phone, not your radio, okay?
Yeah, I cut off the radio.
All right, what's up?
You can hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. I can hear you very well.
Good day to you, and good day to...
Only me one now. My guest gone. Only me one now.
Yes, sir. The nation.
Yes.
And the behemoths of this nation.
Yes.
I had a few inquiries.
Okay.
But one, right? It's ironic in a poor country like this, that we are the Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
You think we poor?
A lot of people hurting.
Okay.
And I think, you know what I'm saying?
I understand.
But it's funny that BOB doesn't allow you to take off in intervals. Like at the location on Robertson Road, I think they allow you to take off 50 or 20 is maybe, I don't know how.
Oh, you mean the breakdown in the money? $50 bills, $20 and the breakdown?
Yeah, but okay. Most of their locations only allow you to take off $100 a time. Sometimes you only need $50.
All right, you sure that right? Because I don't have that issue with them at any place I saw.
You ever took off a $20 bill like back in the day?
Things is behind. I need lunch money and I only get $20 on my account. Yeah, I've done that.
That isn't possible anymore.
The problem that may be is that because so many people used the machine that day, they may have run out of $20 bills and only $50, $100 bills.
It isn't an option when you type.
Really?
It's not an option.
I'll refer that and check that out because I don't know that to be so.
And then the lady deflected from she mentioned that they're fined for debiting at a store. And there's a fee for withdrawing, but she never specifically said what the fee is worth.
Well, no, she didn't go specific because there's...
The nation could hear how unfair it is and the taxation be under by the government and by all these private entities.
I gotcha.
And I would like to really know before your show is over, like, how much is debited, how much is taken away in fees every time you use your credit card at a shop? Or every time you pull into, go to the ATM machine. I'd like to figure that out too.
Okay, I'll do my best to do that for you, okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right. Call you on there. How you doing?
Yeah. I'd like to piggyback on what the last caller said.
Okay.
He actually is correct with the Royal Bank. They don't have a $20 option anymore.
Okay.
And secondly, I know you keep saying about they want to move to the card because safety and robbery.
That's one of the reasons. I don't know if that's the only reason, but that's a reason.
I'll actually take the robbery because I'm not going to travel with my life savings on me at one time.
Fair enough.
But I know that in your card, they can wipe out your whole life savings when they get your card.
Well, that they can wipe out your life savings. Well, she did say now, If there's charges of $50 or less, you can tap. If it's over $50, they will ask you to put your PIN in. And then if it's
I'm just saying it's from experience.
Fair enough.
On my card, I didn't know how it was. I don't know how money came over it.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I got it back, but I had to prove to them that I didn't spend it. But
fair enough. But you know,
I'm just saying, they can wipe out your money off your card.
They can wipe out your money off your bank account, dude. Brother, I hear your point, and there's so much crookedness and so many evil people in our good world. As a young banker back in the day, people using bank books, I've had issues with people had money taken off their account. So I understand what you're trying to say, and it's a risk. And as the banks put more security in, and they verify one bank, if you charge $50 in your bank, you get a WhatsApp or text telling you $50
right.
to charge.
And
if you
another
don't, you,
thing on that, right?
Uh-huh.
I know that why they're moving on to that, because you know that when $50, that same $50 that move around,
uh-huh.
they get to charge that same $50 five times when that same $50 moves to five people.
Same thing with the cash.
Yeah, that's true. But
it's convenient, my brother. I hear your point, and there are challenges. I understand that, but there's convenience and there's safety. I prefer to use my card. I prefer that. I feel more comfortable doing it. But to each his own, and to whoever is comfortable with what you want to do. We're going to take a break. When we get back, we'll wrap up our first hour, and then we'll get more into... I don't know if this was going to take us into this, but this is great. I don't have no problem with that. This is Z Live, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Pearly filling in for Zhivargo Laing today. I've gone after the day, but it's been a great couple of days. Let's see you after the break.
I'm breaking out of this cage. I'm standing up. I'm going to face my demon. I'm manning up. I'm going to hold my ground.
You try to rest. Roll with the best for all your printing needs. There ain't no one better, no. For posters and banners, magazines and flyers, for window decals, greeting cards and newsletters. No job too big and there's no job too small. You name it, we can print it. Just give us a call.
Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life.
Located in the Nassau Guardian Building, telephone 302-2361.
Are you a business owner or HR professional? RF's team of pension specialists are here to empower your employees with market-leading retirement solutions and to make implementing group pensions easy and cost-effective. With RF, starting or switching your company pension plan is a breeze, and there are no setup fees. If you're looking for strong investment performance and low fees, visit rfgroup.com/empower and empower your team to retire comfortably with RF Group Pensions today. That's rfgroup.com/empower.
Craving something delicious and freshly made? Dunkin' has got you covered all day your way. From savory sausage, egg and cheese to crispy bacon, ham, and even tuna, our sandwiches are made to order just for you. Choose your favorite. Bagels, croissant, toast, or muffin. Whatever you want, we've got it. Whether it's a classic grilled cheese or a hearty club, your perfect sandwich is just a bite away. Dunkin's fresh, made-to-order sandwiches made all day, every day, only at Dunkin'. The Bahamas runs on Dunkin'.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid. Take a stand, everybody, everybody. Come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm. Let me know that you're not alone. Holla if you feel like you've been
can't
down
the same
road. And we're back. I almost called the wrong show name. I had to take a breath. Z Live on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Let's read these texts quickly and then we'll get to your caller, okay? Don't go nowhere, caller. Hey, Curly, not Curly, Pearly. Only drug dealers using cash. It amazes me some of the things I hear on this show and people text, but I love it. Don't stop. I opened a BOB savings account a few weeks ago. Firstly, it took 2 weeks to get an appointment, then another couple days to have the account open. Secondly, only one bank in Grand Bahama, and the line is beyond the door sometimes. And please, more ATMs throughout the island. They need more ATMs. RBC does that, where you don't allow you to withdraw 20s, etc. I don't think that's BOB. He has to confirm that it's BOB and not RBC. Okay. And somebody already told me that, quite a number of businesses who jump on the cashless bandwagon without fully analyzing the cost of now going back to cash only. The bank fees are likely too high to justify digital payments. The marketing around digitalization has been wrong-headed because the people pushing it really don't understand their market. This is clear from the PM down to the banks. And if you don't understand your market, talking about digitalization is useless. I quite clear on what that text was saying, but we can go with we can leave that right there. Callie on the air, how you doing?
Yeah, Pearls, what's going on?
Hey, Muff, what's happening?
Man, you have options now. Right now, it's a standard option.
Yes.
When I go in Super Value, I get my stuff, my item, I take out my wallet. You got cash. You either pay for cash or you could use your debit card. When I go to the gas station, I put gas in my car. You could take out cash and pay that, or you could use your debit card. Well, the Chinese and all, I'm so glad now the Chinese got this card and thing now.
Uh-huh.
Now, I with you, boy. Online banking is the best thing to slice bread, boy. What? Really? The other day, you know, I tell BC email me the bill, right?
Uh-huh.
And when I go there, it couldn't open. I couldn't open to see the bill. So I go on a BC, Tucker Road, to let the woman over. Finally, the line was by Mabel Walker.
Okay.
Primary school.
Yeah.
The line was so long. Man, I get that and I run out there. I'm glad I don't go on the line no more. Like you say, I sit down at my house, 10 o'clock in the night, 11 o'clock in the night,
yep.
12 o'clock, I pay in bills, 12 o'clock, 12 midnight. I pay my cable, my internet.
5 minutes.
PC,
5 minutes.
This cell phone here, this postpaid cell phone there.
Yeah.
I pay all of them in my house.
Yep.
Now, and then, but you know, I get the Kia now. But you know, before I had the Lecky.
Yeah.
That's buying $30-$40 gas a day.
Yeah.
So you know, you go to Cable Bahamas, BC, but Telco, all of that. You didn't buy enough for it. I'm saving on $40 or so gas.
Now, no, you're very right. You not only gas, you're saving on time, you're saving on frustration.
Time
on that line, you're saving on everything.
Right. Now, the only problem I have with the bank, what I use, the deposit.
Uh-huh.
Them ATM machines, they much deposit is be wicked, man.
Yes, I've seen that I've seen that issue, and then they need to look at that.
You can't find the deposit. The withdrawal good, but you can't get the deposit.
Yeah.
But now online banking, boy, look here, that saved me so much time and gas and things like that.
Listen, you save your time. I sit down, I get up sometimes, sit down in my boxes 5 minutes, I pay my light bill, my cable bill, my water bill, that's it, I done.
Yeah, me too.
And I get my email receipts. I have a folder in my email. I have a folder. I put all my utilities folder and stuff there. So whenever I need to go back and check, it's right there.
And the statement has come to the end of the month. All you can just go to them and ask them for it.
Yes.
To print it.
I get a statement and my bank actually sends me digital statement that I can go back and check and see what charges came off, what done. I'm trying to figure why short $10. Oh, okay. So I know. And
man,
if it's inquiry,
man,
I make an inquiry.
You know what time I go in these car parts places and things, or the license in your car. You got option with license in your car. And also, Michael is cashless, but last email is cash.
Yeah.
And Fort Charlotte is cash. But you know, every time I go in these parts place, and the bill is like 100 and something, and they say to me, jump into my car, I got to run to the ATM machine, get the money off, and come back, throw the line again. Man, I got my debit card and bang, over there.
Good to go, ready to show.
Yeah, man. Stop being scared of change, man. These people got to stop being scared of change.
Yeah.
This change is for the better.
Yeah.
All right, boys.
Take care, my brother. Thanks for calling. Let's read this couple of texts before we go to the break. Digitalization is for people if you don't understand the people. What exactly are you? Digitalization is for people. If you don't understand the people, what exactly are you doing? That's what it means. Okay. I gotcha. Hey, Pearl, I use online banking. I pay BPL and BTC online. It saves a hassle to that line. Yeah, toting that line. I agree. I don't like toting lines. I don't like going on lines. I'm impatient like that. So if I can sit down on my phone, pay my light bill, pay my cable bill, pay my water bill, and pay whatever the bills I want to pay, do whatever I need to do, it's good. It's fun. I'm fine with that. I have no complaints. You know, I'm able to get that out of the way. I could be eating my breakfast, drinking a cup of coffee, which I do a lot, and don't have to worry about anything. If I don't want paid right away, I can just do all my bills. I ain't got to dress up to go pay no bills. And while some people, like Rochelle said earlier, people would like to do a little networking and meet with old friends and the money. Yeah, that's fine, but I can call you on the phone or WhatsApp you. I'd rather just get that out of the way. I hate towing lines. Oh, boy. Okay, that's our hour up. We're going to take a break. We're going to go to the news. When we come back, we can talk a little bit about what's going on. I need some comments on how you feel about 9 years for all them crimes. The spy bill, you ain't make no changes. I'm interested in that and some whatever else you want to talk about. It's your last hour with me, so let's make it good, okay? This is Pearly, filling in for Zhivargo Laing on Z Live, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. I'll see you right after the news.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM.
I'm not afraid, to take a stand, Everybody, come take my hand, We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm.
And we're back. We're right here. Okay, but I read a couple of texts. But banking aside, what government needs to do about these roads? Why are roads can't last? Texter, you're one of my favorites. And I can bring that up in a minute. Great show as usual, Pearly. I like the online banking to avoid line, but nothing feels better than that physical cash. Cash is still king. I mean, you have that big gunk in your pocket. Yeah, I mean, that's king. Fix the roads. It is amazing. How many potholes in this country. You know, you don't know where the new Popeyes or Wendy's used to be on Mackey Street. Go through that corner. See how much potholes through there. Just that little corner. That's one. Go on Mackey Street. How much potholes on Mackey Street? On Wolf Road. How much potholes on Nassau Street? Man, I keep saying, fix the potholes. I can talk about this till I drive and know I don't hit a pothole and mess up my tire. Fix the potholes. Fix the roads. Do them properly. And so they're going to stop playing domino in the back there and fix the roads. It is terrible. It gets to me to see how lousy we are when it comes to maintenance in this country. And then we talk about we don't want government to take this over because they don't know how to take care of it. They don't know how to maintain it. We don't know how to maintain things. And because my party in power, I ain't going to do this. Or my party in the power, I ain't going to do that. Just fix the roads, man. You hire a job. The pothole patrol, I call them, get in your little truck and drive around Nassau and fix the potholes. You ain't working an hour. Give them 2 more hours. Fix the potholes. Call you on there. How you doing?
Pleasant evening.
Hey, what's up?
Now,
if you're with me, or you ain't with me. Because, you know, it's not like you ain't with me too good. Are you there?
Yeah.
All right, no, talk to me.
I seen the banana.
You can't eat banana and talk to me and I'm hungry. No, man, you can't do that.
Okay, listen to
I miss you. Lunch, you know, so I'm hungry right now. You could tell me you're eating banana.
I get hungry. I tell the woman, go something. I said, give me a banana and tell you for them.
Right, but at least you get someone to cook for you. But anyway, go ahead, brother.
Yeah, I call, anyhow, I ain't tell you that. I called somebody this morning.
Uh-huh.
All right? Another talk shows. And he gone silent on me or he cut me off. I trying to tell him, okay, let me ask you something. What do you feel about the Mason Lodge?
Let's talk with something else.
See, I guess that's what he said when he hanged me up.
No, I am. Full disclosure, I am a Mason. I am a Mason.
Probably years too. So
all right, but you know what I feel about it is a wonderful institution. It's some good camaraderie among some good men, and they do some good things. That's the best I'm going to say about it right now.
Okay, good.
Fair enough.
Yeah. You ain't right. Getting trouble saying that.
Okay. What's your next question? Let's move on.
Okay. Listen to what I'm saying.
Uh-huh.
Well, since you on that line of thought, I just feel that from what I know, because past grandmaster Duke Hanna, he died now.
Uh-huh.
And he told me one thing about the Mason. He said one time he went to Washington to do a meeting.
Uh-huh.
And he said when he reached Washington, he find out that he leave his wallet. And that's all.
Okay.
So he said, boy, what are you doing now? So he going to try the airport because he can't catch no taxi, he can't get none.
Uh-huh.
He going outside and stand a Satan with you. Hold on. Hold up, man. And this fella stop on the side, skirt.
Uh-huh.
He say, man, the fella was amazing.
Uh-huh.
And he said, man, boy, I spent more money than I had in my wallet back in Nassau. Because the fella just take care of him.
Okay.
I say that to say this. Some of these court cases, like a concurrent thing.
Anyway. Leave that right there, because first, I ain't gonna let you go there. I see where you're trying to go right now, and I appreciate you being very guarded, but it don't work like that. It doesn't. If it did work like that, I would have been had some other things a lot better. So it doesn't work like that, okay? Ah, boy. I concerned about something, and he did say the court case, all right? And I brought it up, and I want to read this to you, because this, I am so disturbed by this, okay? Says here, okay, a man who carried out a string of violent crimes against women, among them a rape of an 83-year-old, was sentenced to 9 years imprisonment yesterday as part of a plea deal. Joel Sean, 22, pleaded guilty to rape, housebreaking, 4 counts of armed robbery, and assault with intent to rape when he appeared before Justice Jeanine Reach Gomez. On December 31st, 2022, Strawn carjacked Miss Sanders of a Toyota, while she waited for her daughter to come out of the nail salon. The prosecutor said to the court, when arrested, Strawn said he took the car with him in intent to avenge the murder of his brother, who was reportedly killed by a gang based in the Grove. While he's on bail for that holdup, Strawn carried out 3 violent crimes within days of each other in June of 2022. Strawn on June broke into a 30-year-old woman's home in Chippingham, robbed her of jewelry valued at $850, and attempted to rape her. The woman fought Strawn on, and he tried to remove her pants, but he masturbated instead. He was seen on security footage jumping over a wall as he fled the home. Come on. I mean, come on. You see all this guy, and he get 9 years? I mean, say crime don't pay? 9 years for all of that? I understand it's a plea deal. I understand that we don't want to waste the court's time. But my goodness, 9 years? When you're not going to do the full year because it's not 12 months of the jail year? So you might be out in 5 years? Call you on the air.
Hello.
Hi.
Yeah, that's me again.
All right, what happened? you got to be guarded. My producer is very, very, very protective of me. So you got to be very guarded on what you say. So I don't want you to say nothing that can cause Erica call me.
Tell your producer.
Easy now.
54316. Was my mother's direct number.
of the Nassau Guardian, all right? Her name is Ellen Tucker.
You ain't got to... Hold on, Carla. Talk to me. Let's don't go there. Talk to me. Let's don't go there. Talk to me. What is your point? What is the point you want to raise? Raise your point. Go ahead.
No, you said you didn't want to touch that.
I want to be very careful of what I say because I just want to be guarded about what you say. So I don't want you to try and say somebody get off because of the lodge and I ain't allowed that because that's not so. Okay?
Yeah.
Whether it happens in this country or not, in this case, I don't see that. Okay? Fair enough? I thank you. Oh, Lord of mercy, hear my prayer. Let me say this. I am told that I allow you to say what you want to say. And I allow people to come and talk because I want to hear what you got to say and then we'll have a conversation. But what I'm not going to allow is you to come on the show and say things that you have no proof of. Yeah, we had this little rumor. We had a little talk around town and there's been something going on from when I was a little boy. Once in the lodge, you ain't got to worry about nothing. If you do a certain sign when you get in the court, you can get off and all that stuff. I cannot say I've seen that happen. I cannot say. And maybe it has. Pearly cannot say he's seen that happen. And unless you could bring me specific evidence of it that proves it, I can't let you say that. Because I have an obligation to my management team. I have an obligation to my listeners, our sponsors, and IRCA watching. So I have to make sure that we do responsible journalism here. We have a responsible dialogue here. And we talk things that are factual and that are truth. I don't know if that happened, but until you could prove that to me, my brother, I can't let you say that. I can't allow you to say that because that's not fair to everybody involved. That's all I'm saying. Now, I am outraged that this brother only get 9 years. I am outraged that this brother only get 9 years. How can something like that happen? Why is something like that happening? And like I said, I understand you don't want to waste the court's time. But, great show as usual. Give him 4 life sentences plus 99 years. Keen him every 9 hours. Now, that's cruel. Great show as usual. As soon as he gets bail, he might not live 5 hours. Nassau is a serious place when it comes to vigilante justice. Teach me the sign so I could go to BPL Tulum. I pissed he got 9 years, Pearly Keenan. He needs to be out on jail, yes, then justice will be served if you know. No, but see, that ain't justice. That's vigilante justice. See, we as women ain't serious. Get married, you can't cry rape, a little girl molested, pedophile is out before she could vote. Elderly woman gets raped by a man who could be her grandchild 9 years. This country households are ruled by women, yet we stand for this. A crying shame. Give him a taste of his own medicine in jail. Boy, Pearly, as the taxi driver, after coming off that smooth airport road and passing the red light on Bay Street, it feels like I'm riding on an unpaved road and guests always asking, why is it like that? Fix the roads, people. Fix the roads. Hey, Pearly, the road below the hill by the Guardian is a disgrace. They need to pave that road right away. Fix the roads. Pearly, great show. So refreshing on another note, we already paying for well water because every time the water pumps on, you runs up your light bill. That, you know, people have been talking about that and asking questions about that. Next day, I know this less in severity, but Bishop Roll got scammed. That caused some people. In light of this, I think it will also be impactful giving some safety and lookout tips. Like if someone is asking you to send them thousands of dollars, don't have that conversation by text. I agree. And there's a scam going around, some fellas around here calling you on your WhatsApp and for somehow cloning your WhatsApp and then coming back like they clone my good friend Bishop Minnis. And next thing I get is text saying, hey, how you doing? I need $550 right away. I say, let me see what you're saying. What you need it for? I say, why don't you come and pick it up? I buy my office. Come by my office and pick it up. No, I can't come. I say, well, how Nikki? Oh, Nikki, all right. I say, well, send Nikki. No, I send Nikki. Nikki don't exist. Nikki don't exist. So the next few things, I can't say on radio what I said to them. Some really, really heavy words. One begin with F and then B and S and stuff like that. Bad words. So you got to be guarded. So if I get a strange call now, I don't even answer it. And if I do answer it and that voice don't sound right, I hang that up and I block that right away. So we do have a lot of dishonest people in this good world of ours. And we have the people that are just trying to scam you, and you have to be very guarded by that. So anything we do, people can try. They try swinging out your money, your cash money. They try to rob you. They'll try to take your card. So it's just about you being vigilant and what you do and how you charge. And you don't just charge them. You don't let people have your credit card or your debit card number for just anything. Somebody call you on the phone and say, you're doing this, and you give them. No, what you give them the card for? Why would you give anybody your password? Or your PIN number? Why would you give that to anybody? If a person calls and says something they won't confirm, tell them that's okay. I go on into the bank to confirm it myself. Do not give information on the phone that you don't know you're talking to. Do not do that. A lot of people get swinged. A lot of people get scammed, not because the scam is good, because you're not too believing. I had this woman text me and say, hi, how you doing? I think you're so this, you're so that. Now my head done swelling. I have $7.8 million that my parents led. They were killed. And I'm in a refugee camp in Somalia. And I need to get out. And I want to send the money to you. And then I'll come to you. And I'll be your wife. And I'll live with you. I just gone through a divorce now. So I'm like, And I'm talking. I said something. I said, really, go with the flow. So I got, next thing, look, this English guy called me. And tell me, oh, you have the money available, and he can send the money to me. Just send $1,800 for the Federal Express thing. I say, hold on. You got $7.8 million for me. Take the $1,800. I say, you know what? Take $200. I say, no, take $500,000. I say, no. Let's do it like this. Take $1 million of that. You could have that. Pay everything. Buy the woman the plane ticket. Make sure she come for his class and send her straight to the Bahamas. And don't worry. Oh, no, I can't do that. So the next thing was click, block. But I say all that to say, I was just getting off on them and having a good time that day. But be very guarded by who you talk to. Be very guarded by who you give your information to. And you'll be fine, You're going to have some issues at times. And that's how we deal with those issues. Let's take this caller, and then we can take a break right after this caller. Caller on the air, how you doing?
I'm well. How are you?
Thank God for life. You know, my new saying is, thank God for pain. I figure if I feel in pain, I alive. So how you doing?
That's right. Thank God for life. I had a scenario like what you just expressed myself, and I said the same thing. If I have to send you money to send me the money, just deduct it out of what you owe me.
Exactly.
They hang up that phone so quick.
They changed that talk.
But listen, I don't agree with your stance. I was listening to you yesterday.
Okay.
On third parties.
Okay.
Right? You know how many doors Kentucky, the colonel, knocked on before anybody gave him a chance?
Quite a few.
And you see how popular Kentucky is today?
Yes. I heard that story, yes.
Okay. So, I think that if people were more aware of how things ran in this country, they may have an inkling,
okay. Okay.
But we don't, even though we do have a Freedom of Information Act,
That ain't where it's supposed to be.
It's not as accessible to the regular citizen as it should be, right?
I agree.
And I think that if more people knew exactly how, how things were operating,
uh-huh.
Because we can improve on a lot of stuff in this country. It's not saying that we didn't do anything, but after 50 years, we need to progress,
yes.
Right? And it's okay to be different. As long as you're a Bahamian citizen, you have a right to
yes.
want change, right?
Yes.
And I don't think that people should discourage persons, right?
Uh-huh.
And bring them down because they want to do things different.
I understand that. I understand your point.
Okay. I'm a qualified person. I'm over 50. I'm a CPA for 30, 40 years.
Yes.
And I actually applaud persons that want to be different, take that chance to do things different, right? Because, we've progressed to a point, but at some point, you need to get better,
And I agree with you 100%. And like I said, I don't have a problem with anybody who wants to be in a third party, a fourth party, or any party like that. I have no problem with that. That's just my personal view.
Yeah.
My personal, you know, I like yeah. I respect somebody who wants to
I heard
change.
A talk show host, not to cut you off. Uh-huh. I mean, you're like, what? How a person could even try to head up anything? Because he's a Bahamian, for example. He's a Bahamian. Any person in this country, you don't have to have money, right?
No.
Well, you don't.
In politics in this country, you do.
Back up your idea. You have some facts. Let's do. Let's go. Right?
The way politics in this, and I don't know if you, the way politics working in this country now, in our good little Bahamas, if you ain't got no money, there ain't nothing happening.
Yeah, that's why the system has to change.
It sure
because
does.
See that same talk right there?
Uh-huh.
You have young people whose parents worked in straw market, taxi, and you hear in this talk, right? And then
yeah.
you heard the talk.
Yeah.
When your child comes here, your parents gone for second grade, fifth grade, but they was able to get enough money to set and be able to keep the family together and send
yeah.
one of their children
uh-huh.
off.
Uh-huh.
When they come back home, you're telling them they're overqualified. This is the kind of thing. That is why the system needs to change.
No, but I understand what I'm saying. I'm not saying money to put in my pocket, you know. You got to pay a rent for a headquarters. You got to have transportation. You got to have food for your people. You have to have posters, T-shirts, flyers. All that costs a ton of money.
Yeah, yeah.
It takes money to run an election campaign.
Yeah, you've heard a lot of people talk lately about, what do you call it, transparency regarding campaign.
I'm all for campaign finance reform. I'm all for that.
We need to push for those kinds of things if we want to progress in this country.
I agree with you.
It creates, you know what it does? It creates a level playing field for all persons, right? And nobody should condemn anybody. I don't think there's a person that live in a glass house in this country.
No.
Everybody has a situation. You're not perfect.
No,
but,
you're not. I agree with
okay?
you. In every
okay,
aspect
so don't
of those,
disparage.
You're not.
I, you know, I don't like people when they disparage people, you know, from trying to do something different. You know, that's what you do when you want to stifle yourself or your country.
And your point is very valid. Your point is very valid. But I can say this much: everybody can lead Pearly.
You know, how long was the F&M in the wilderness?
The F&M was formed in 71 and didn't win until 92.
How long were they in
but
the
were,
wilderness
but they
before
were not,
they got a chance?
They were not the third party. They were the second party. The
but
third parties.
How long were they?
I'm not disputing they were in power. They were out there for 20 years before they got elected.
Right.
But
yeah,
they were
so
not.
It takes somebody else longer, but at least, you
they
know,
they were
may
not. You're still missing my argument here. They were
go
not
ahead.
The third party. They were the second party. There was no third. All the third parties that came up during that folded. All the third parties that tried to run folded. That's the only argument
yeah.
I'm saying. Because
we might have been like if we really, you know, wanted better for this country, you know, we could give other people a chance.
As Bahamians,
you know.
I hear that argument, and that's a very good argument. But I'm giving you a chance, and you make sense to me, not because you come up and say I want to change, and I'm the third. I'm not giving you a chance if you can't make sense to me. I'm not giving you a chance if you can't show me that your program is better, not because you protest, not because you row and carry on and stand in front
but
of this place.
I hear
and
that.
Doesn't make
that.
You.
And you
I
have
know.
A valid point as well.
Give me your plan.
But I think that a lot of people, because they don't think that that could work, or they are so involved in their red and they're yellow, right? They don't even have the mindset to open up, to accept, or to read something that was put out by a third party. Because there's been a lot of information put out there, you know, and it may not be completely 100% correct in all aspects, but there is something to it. Like our natural resources, there is something to it, right? That's why we created a whole, you know, why go through that whole process of even creating a ministry? But anyway, I just wanted to say that.
No, I appreciate that, and I thank you for
you.
Your call. Thank you so much, my dear. Mr. Producer, let me take this one call, let me take a break. Call you on there, how you doing?
Hey, Pearly, how are you this afternoon?
Thank God for life, I'm good.
What they have to realize about third party in this country, third parties are not viable in this country. You know how far back we had third parties? Go back as far as the Vanguard, okay?
I forgot about the Vanguard.
Third party we had. Now we have a new up-and-coming third party similar to the Vanguards, okay? Do you think the Bahamian people are going to take a chance with a bunch of radical people? Come on, if you have a plan, express your plan to the Bahamian people and do it in an orderly manner. You can't be disrespecting people and want people to follow you. Pearly, 50
hey.
Plus 1 is a winning,
yep.
okay? And they're nowhere near not even 1% of the population. Have a nice day.
Thank you for calling. And like you think about it, you had the NDP, the Vanguard, the Workers' Party, the BDM, the CDR, the DNA. And I know I leave a couple, the Christian party. You had a lot of parties, third parties, that just wasn't viable, didn't form. Z Live, Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, this Pearly in the house for Zhivargo. We'll be right back after this break.
Do you have uncontrollable debt? Are you ready to make that move to Fidelity for a stress-free future? These loans have a built-in savings plan that pays you unbeatable interest. Ask about our debt consolidation loans today. Call 356-7764.
Fidelity, we're good for you.
When you jump in your Japanese import and you turn the radio on, all you hear is... For the month of September, the HitSpot will install a band extender in your Japanese import for the discounted rate of only $79.99, VAT included. Get your band expander installed today at the HitSpot and listen to
Star 106.5.
Plus, get fresh news and smart talk on
Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Bahamas, are you ready? Keep the Vibe Alive Music Group, along with Alpha Sounds, presents the best of the best, Raking, Scrape, Explosion, Reloaded. This is the biggest one-day all-Bahamian concert of the year. Featuring KB, D-Mac, Abby, Mama D, Fine Sean, Shine 242, The Falcons, and more. Mark your calendars. It's going down November the 2nd at Super Club Breezes Ground. Tickets now available at BahamasEtickets.com or both Beauty Shack location. General admission $60. VIP Skybox and Sky Pods also available. For more info, call 394-0819 or email keep the vibe alive 242 at gmail.com. Experience the magic once again with more legends for one night only. Come party with us November 2nd at Best of the Best. Rake and Scrape Explosion Reloaded.
Why? Why you look so mashed up, like clothes at the washer?
No, boy, just a hard day, boy.
Hard day? What happened? The breakfast lady ran out of tuna and gritsy.
You need to start joking with everything, you know. This serious, boy. This real serious, boy.
Wait, what's serious? Tell me.
All right, well, today, boss gave us, boy, one big, big contract. And nobody else get a chance and nobody say nothing.
Boy, you know that ain't right. You know government contracts ain't supposed to go that way.
Yeah, but nobody saying nothing. Boss man just tell people to sign the papers. Then he sent me to meet his boy downtown and collect this envelope.
You need to tell somebody. You need to become a whistleblower.
You know I's a real man, but I never blow no whistle. I be drunk all my life in Junkano.
No way. A whistleblower is someone who tells people what they see when they see something wrong happening at work.
But I ain't no whistleblower, and I ain't no snitch. I still wait there, you know.
Boy, ain't nobody gonna know it's you. All you gotta do is call Crime Stoppers, or you could text them from inside the Crack Crime Bahamas app. They don't ask about you. And your call goes straight through to Miami, so nobody know you is. And if you text, your message get mixed up like Kong Salad.
Call 328-8477 from Nassau, or 242-300-8477 from the Family Islands.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, quality.
I'm not afraid to take a stand, everybody, everybody, come take my hand, we'll walk this road together, through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm, let me know that you're not alone, I love if you feel like you
and can. We're back. We're back. Z Live, Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. This is Pearly. But this is some. But my text is getting me now. This, the whole idea, Pearly, it's a secret organization, so you can't bring proof of evidence if you're not a part of that brotherhood. They're also trying to steal your Facebook and other accounts. Persons told me they lock out of their Facebook. Mind you, they texting me on Facebook. Tell me if I can confirm a code to send them. If I had done that, they would have definitely stolen my Facebook account. Be mindful. Yeah, don't. What you sending them code for? They need no code. I come to you right now, caller. The great show as usual. Put a guy in jail who did the horrible act, the same cell with Puff Daddy, and throw six balls of baby oil in it. since the government don't want to hang him. Really, if that gal was a mango, you would have sent the 1800. She was pie. She was a Russian, blonde hair, blue-eyed, pretty, pretty lady when she sent me that picture. Your caller is using the wrong example because chicken is like crack cocaine to us black people. We would buy the chicken even if the place was named NSC. We just like chicken. I understand that. But that third party hasn't folded. They're still holding. They ran one election. One. So let's see what happens after this election. I'm not saying they're not going to hold, you know. I've never seen the evidence of it holding. Every third party has folded after the most two elections. The third party can give you a concept of a plan. You know. Caller, talk to me, caller. You have a concept of a plan?
Pearly Gates.
What's happening?
Listen to me.
I'm listening good.
The FNM is a political party.
Yes, it is.
The PLP is political party.
Yes, it is.
The COI is an event or social. The difference between a social and a party.
Okay.
Parties have music and plenty food, plenty drinks, and plenty dance.
Uh-huh.
COI is a social. I'm a betting man.
Okay.
I'll take a chance and bet. The COI doesn't get half as much votes in the 2026 election as they got in the first election.
Okay.
Okay?
Now, I can take something. That bet because I signed with you on that one. I can go to money line.
Yeah, but let me say something with that.
Uh-huh.
The COI cannot find, you need at least 20 seats.
Yeah.
To be the government.
Yes.
The COI can't name, and politics is like a popularity contest.
Yeah.
Popular people win.
Yeah.
The COI can't find five, the four popular people to say name as a candidate. Them names, I hear they run up 19 names the other night.
Uh-huh.
I know two of them.
And that's Lincoln and who?
I am a kind of popular person.
And that's Lincoln and
that's
who?
Lincoln being, I didn't even hear they call the Dachshund woman.
Yeah, she gone, I think, either Bamboo Town or Pinewood, yeah. Not Bamboo Town, sorry.
She back in Bamboo Town again?
That's what they say, yeah. She's one of the 19.
Listen, in the election gone, when they had the advance poll,
uh-huh.
She was sitting under the tent with Miss Patricia DeVoe. I hope she could have voted in Bamboo Town because I believe she might have voted for her.
Well, she may have been just using because she had no tent. I don't know.
No, but they just... See, Lincoln Bean has... You must give it to him. He has some ideas.
Yes, he does. He has some stickability, yes.
The only way he can make a difference is he has to get into one of the major parties and work from in there.
That's my belief, that you should join these parties and work,
and
bring
work
change
from
it.
But
bring
he
change
get
from it.
The FNM and the PLP ain't want him. So now he on his own. That's the only reason why he's still floating around over there.
I understand.
But watch the people that he is attracting. You need popular people. You need popular names. You need a name, and when they say, man, Pearly, they can put a face right to your name.
Yes, yes.
That's what you need for politics.
Yeah. That's the mayor. That's the mayor. That's the man from Chippenham. Okay. I know him. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
I know Jimmy.
You know what they call your name? Being a politician, they should put your face straight to your name.
Yeah. Yeah.
You don't have to wonder who granddaddy was. Who granddaddy? Is he granddaddy?
And I can be honest. I can be honest with the 19 people I knew, the leader, the deputy leader, and Dachshund. And that's the only three people out of that 19.
But
I know.
I didn't even hear Dachshund name, but I was laughing so much.
Yeah.
But Dachshund and him.
Yeah.
They'll be the two I know.
And I know that Dr. MacGyver. I know her well, too. I don't know her well, but I heard
about the... I wonder if that's the woman or the man.
That's the lady. She's...
No, I know the man.
That's one of the sisters. Well, that's his ex-wife or his wife.
Okay, I know of the man.
Yeah, she's related. She's related to Elaine from Bamboo Shack and their sisters, the Williams girls.
Okay, I think, honestly,
uh-huh.
I think this is going to be the biggest opposition we have had in a while. But I don't see the FNM beating the PLP.
Time will tell.
And if the PLP is smart enough, there are some people that they need to, I wouldn't say throw out, but rest it aside.
Throw out. You that'd be nice. Throw out. They need not to run some people.
In 15 months.
They need not to run a bunch of them.
Name people in there.
Yeah.
They have them in problems. I mean, they're down in problems, but they'll be almost in the same position they're in. And in closing, let me say this.
Uh-huh.
I got to say this publicly to you.
Okay.
As long as Hubert Minnis, the Honorable former Prime Minister Hubert Minnis is alive, it's going to be very, very, very hard for Michael Pintard to beat Brave David. Because he has he's fighting two fights.
I got you.
He had to fight off Minnis.
Well, he done do that. He already fight off Minnis. He did that June 1st. That done. So I don't see that fight happening no more.
Minnis dead. Minnis might ease a little while, but don't think Minnis dead. Minnis ain't going to go down to that bracket.
All right, time.
You see, you know what Minnis thing is? They couldn't win the by-election without him advancing in Bimini. That's his talk.
That, but I don't think they could have been the by-election of Essendon Bimini with Hubert Ingram, they couldn't win it. But Hubert Ingram was then, they couldn't win it. So I don't...
His era may be over, but his influence isn't. And a 26-year-old daughter. My daughter heard about Hubert Ingram before.
Yeah.
My son named him Hubert Ingram.
Yeah.
He teach in school. He could tell me with Christopher Columbus and I walked.
Yeah.
Okay. He teach in school. They don't have them no more.
Oh, you see. But I don't think the fact that Minnis was not at the by-election was a factor where they've been a loss. That was too much money to go up against.
Because he wasn't there. If you don't go with the world-famous Wally boys and they get beat, you can say, man, you only win because I was in there. You see the trick in that?
I got you. I got on that one. I got a couple more callers. Amazing. Call you on there. How you doing?
Pleasant good afternoon again.
Listen, why you keep calling? Go ahead. Go ahead, brother. Go ahead.
Okay. Now you're talking about a third party.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Do you remember the BDP that was under Henry Bosquick in 1977?
That was when the Free National Movement split, the BDP, and they had the PLP, the BDP, and the FNM contested the 1977 general election. And at the end of the day, the BDP became the official opposition.
Yeah.
And then they realized it couldn't happen the way they did, so they merged to become back the FNDM, the Free National Democratic Movement, and then eventually by 1982 general elections, they dropped the D and went back to the full FNM. Yes, I know about it. When it comes to political history, I'm very, very astute.
Yeah, but I'm not saying there was a third party that made a footprint.
I'm not saying they don't make a footprint, but they don't last. They did not make it to the 82 general election. There was just two parties at the 82 general election again.
Okay.
Well, you understand my point? I'm not disputing that you have you can go a third party. I'm not disputing that. Listen, the DNA affected the 2012 general election. I believe that fully. I believe that the FNM may have won the election. Or would have fared better in that election if the DNA wasn't in the election. But the DNA got 13,000 votes.
DNA full of disgruntled FNMs.
They shorted, but the DNA got, 13,000 votes, a bunch of votes in that election, and the next election didn't get half as much as they got the last time.
Yeah.
Okay? That's just my point. Thank you. Appreciate that. Call you on there. How you doing?
Hey, good day. How you doing?
Thank God for life. What's up?
Yeah, I'm looking into the talk show, and I've called him before the last one. You can just hear that he's actually just a PLP.
That's fine. I'm open to anybody who want to call in. That's fine.
Yeah, but I mean, it's just so sad that you believe, that we have to believe that someone has to be popular for us to get their vote. And I think that's what have us in this downward spiral right now. Believing that we have to vote for someone popular. That doesn't even make sense.
I think what he's trying to say, and I don't want to interpret for him, I don't think he's meaning popular as in famous. I'm talking about if you come in and run and chipping out, I want to know who you are, where you from, or what your background is. Don't come give me a stranger in chipping out and tell me you can represent me because you know nothing about chipping out if you ain't from there. So I think that's what he's meaning. People who are known to the community.
No, I understand your point with that he ain't from Chippenham.
Yeah.
And he came to represent you.
Yeah.
But someone just being popular.
Understand.
Doesn't deserve credit for the vote.
I understand your point.
I believe that you should hear their ideas, their views, and make the best man win.
Point. And be able to sell your idea, because don't tell me you want...
Yeah, be able to sell it.
Don't tell me you want to do something, then when I ask you questions, but if you can answer it, then you... That ain't going to work for me.
Yeah, all right, understood.
I appreciate it. Thank you, brother. Call you on there. How you doing? Impatient people. Call you on there. How you doing?
Hey, Billy, what's happening?
Hey, what's up?
Right here, boy. Listen, I just listened to the past, previous three callers.
Okay.
And there's some points here that we have to consider here. First and foremost, you know, you talk about politics being a popularity contest.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. This is one of the reasons why we are where we are today, because many politicians who are famous today actually came from an unknown, okay? Sometimes it takes situations like this for you to become known. Now, the only thing that I would say in this regard is, you know, when we're selecting candidates, the candidates should actually come from the area that they desire to represent.
Or be a descendant of the area.
Exactly, because okay. They have a pulse of what's truly happening on the ground, one, and two, the people of that particular area or constituency would already be, would already know your familiar origins or yeah, who your people are, so you already have some credibility. When you start talking about popularity in politics, like I said, this is why we are where we are today. And the DNA. I heard the mention of the DNA. The DNA in the 2012 general election garnered for the first time for a third party 13,168 votes.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay, and yes, the DNA is not. And let's change this perception that a lot of people have. The DNA entirely was not solely disgruntled FNMs.
No, they were not.
The DNA was a cross-section of FNMs, disgruntled PLPs, and those who did not belong to any political party, but only desired to see a change in the political construct that we see going on today.
Yes.
And if we do not get to change our mindsets, and I'll close on this one, if we do not change our mindsets and stop this popularity contest, because I'm going to tell you, right now, currently, I don't see anything really, truly happening for the average Bahamian on the ground today. Okay? With all of the money that's being sent and all the successes that's claimed to be going on in this country, the average Bahamian in this country is at a very disgruntled stage where there's nothing happening for them. The Bahamas is here for us to fix, and until we stop this popularity contest and select people who genuinely have a love and an interest for the Bahamian people, for the prosperity that we deserve, we will continue to get what we get today, okay?
Thanks for calling, my brother. We read this text. We need to do something about these petty thieves. Y'all thieves listening, y'all need to buy your own stuff and respect people's things. I just saw a video last night of a man going into a woman's yard to steal her drop cord for her air condition. You should see the amount of struggle and work he had to do just to get the drop cord. They stealing so easily, and these people blaming it on government. I live in the same increased cost of living as everyone else, and ain't stooped to having to be taking people things. Mr. Braley, I need the secret handshake. Mr. Braley, I agree with you about the third party. They fold up. BDP joining with the FNM, DNA and CDR fold. BDP in the 77. Mr. Ingram is a popular person. No one ever joined any political party and was able to make a change except Ingram, and that's because he became leader and the party was desperate. None of these parties are in desperation now. And listen, Burley, you need to go back, Seabreeze. It's the same. I love living in Chippenham, yeah? I love living in Chippenham. That's why I born and that's why I bred. And I actually feel safe in Chippenham that I felt in Seabreeze, because I know I get back up in Chippenham. This is Z Live on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. This Pearly filling in for Zhivargo. We can take a quick break. Caller, don't go nowhere. Please don't go nowhere. We can take a break, and when we get right back, I can take that call.
It's Whopper Wednesday every Wednesday at Burger King Nassau. Make your Wednesday sizzle and sink your teeth into a flame-grilled beef patty topped with tomatoes, fresh-cut lettuce, mayo, pickles, ketchup, and sliced onions, all on a toasted sesame seed bun with fries for only $5.95, including VAT. This Whopper Wednesday, grab a friend and head down to your favorite BK Nassau location for a flame-grilled Whopper made your way with crisp fries for only $5.95. Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
Are you a business owner or HR professional? RF's team of pension specialists are here to empower your employees with market-leading retirement solutions and to make implementing group pensions easy and cost-effective. With RF, starting or switching your company pension plan is a breeze, and there are no setup fees. If you're looking for strong investment performance and low fees, visit rfgroup.com/empower and empower your team to retire comfortably with RF Group Pensions today. That's rfgroup.com/empower.
Babe, you mashed the car?
I
I mashed the car. The lady who ran into me mashed the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull up the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. You can buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Now is the time to reach your Grand Bahama market with affordable packages, including print and digital. Call GB News sales representative Kavandre at 822-6717 or message him on WhatsApp for ad rates. Classified ads are now available every Tuesday as well. Keep up with everything Grand Bahamian every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
I'm not afraid, I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand.
And we're back. Z Live on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. This Pearly. Let's read this text. Caller coming right now. Let me read this two last texts. This isn't the same guy who sat at the marble table. Good afternoon, Pearly. With all due respect, being on the ground, I think people are going to be surprised. So, Pearly, are you sleeping chipping on with all them dogs barking and fighting in the night? They my bodyguards. They are my bodyguards. I when I lay down, and if I don't hear the dogs, I know everything good. As soon as I hear the dogs making noise, somebody who ain't supposed to be walking through that corner, walking through the corner, and I can double check. Caller on there, how you doing?
Hey, Pearly.
Yes, sir.
What's happening?
Hey, right here, man. What you saying?
Hey, listen. I tell you, Todd, he could do it, you know. But only thing, they need the money. You can't come off stepping.
That's my argument.
I've said that before, and I'll say it again.
That is my argument.
They can match with the money and the good candidates. See, when you got the money, you can draw the good candidates.
But how you, just the money, and the people ain't giving money just to anybody. You got to prove yourself. I've been involved with sitting with donors and listening to them and seeing how they drilling you and asking you where you spending this money, what you spend. Once they give it to you, they ain't coming to ask you for an itemized thing because they know you desperate politics. But they come into you ahead of time and say, what you going to do? I giving you $100,000. What you going to do with this money?
That's what I said. They need, see, they got to match the PLP them and somebody, the PLP got about $10 million and they got to come up with about $11
million. Yeah, if you don't come up with that number.
They can't hire the candidates. They could do it.
When 500,000 can't be no government for you. And it isn't. And when I tell the people you need money, and I'm not talking about bribing. I'm just talking about paying for 39 headquarters. Not just paying for them. You got to pay the rent. You got to pay the light bill. You got to put cable in it. You got to decorate it. You got to put furniture in it.
You got to pay people to help campaign.
You got to give them something to help campaign. At least feed them.
Now, that lady running, the MacGyver lady, I think she's a good candidate. If she... But only on one,
Why do you think she's a good candidate?
Huh?
Why do you think she's a good candidate?
Well, number one, I think she got the resources.
Okay, does that make you a good candidate because you got the money?
Well, that's one of the issues.
Okay.
See, you could go there as a candidate, but you ain't got nothing to come up with. That's it. Now, it's only on one, and if the party, like I said, they ain't got no money.
Have you had a conversation with her to see what her plans are? Have we found out what her plans are?
That's what I'm saying. You could talk with her. I think she may have a plan. That's what I believe.
A concept of a plan.
Yeah, but then you come in there, you're making all the noise, and then you ain't got no funds to back up your campaign and this and that. Ain't nothing happening.
Because I know, I've seen people, you know, if you campaign and you come in there 4 o'clock, you going all till 8 o'clock, you tired. You ain't been home to cook no dinner. You ain't been home to do nothing, and you come back to the headquarters and expect when mailing the man say thanks for coming and shake hand and give you one soda and a pack of biscuit. Man, I ain't coming back there.
No, again, I can repeat myself. You need the candidate at some good Conrad Cassie. Once you got the money, you can draw some good.
But if you have the funding to support it and have the funding to pay for the things, to get the T-shirts,
you don't get by that election, but next election. Trust me. Now, one more thing I want to say.
I gotcha.
About the banking, because I don't want to talk on that.
Okay.
The banking, we have more fraud going on more than ever before.
We know about the fraud because of social media and because of digitalization. But plenty fraud was going on back then. We didn't know about it. Plenty bank book was getting to. We didn't know back then.
Yeah, no bank book. Nobody. I tell you right now. They try to take my book from me. one particular bank, and I tell them, here you all give me book, or I leave in yours. And they quickly give me book. Yeah, my buddy, and guess what? 10 months after that, they like going to do a little transaction, you know, more than 2 months. They say, man, we got 3 pages. I say, for who? Not for me. And then they put me in their office, and they show me all this transaction take place. So I say to say this, if I didn't have no book, and I didn't know what was going on, I'd have been out of plenty of money. And they took me in and they showed me how much money was going off. I say, now, y'all know I come here to get all our money. And so they took me in, they called a lawyer and whatever. But they took about a week or so to put back my money. But I go to say, if I didn't have no book and I go to the post office waiting for their statement and this and that, heaven knows how much movement is going off.
Well, nowadays, everything is digital. You get your statement on right away, right now.
Yeah,
you
call up a statement right now. Digitally, but guess what?
What?
The people fraud like nothing. You remember the other time the fella put this thing over there and people was side swiping your money?
Oh, yeah, I know.
That's a target I'm talking for.
No, I know. I think my son bought something from a shipping company and for $110, and he got charged that 11 times.
Wow, that's what I'm trying to tell you. You got to be careful what goes on. But anyhow.
Okay, brother.
I talk to you another day.
All right. Read this text and we'll take the call up. What happened to my phone? Okay. The ideal image of a prime minister in the Bahamas is Sir Lyndon Pinden. He stands as a measuring stick by which we define a good prime minister. By, I think, he sets such a high standard that every other prime minister seems to fall short. I just wanted to send my condolences to Mr. Laing and his family at this time of his time of bereavement. Pearly, tell him dogs barking is the least of your worries. Living in Chepenham, the gunshots is what to worry about. Pearly, I will talk to the F&M to get you back in good parts of Seabreeze, the picket fence part. Listen, I don't hear no gunshots. When I hear gunshots, I don't mean Chepenham, be Bantan. I tell you, I feel safe in Chepenham than I feel in Seabreeze. Leave me, man. Leave me in Chepenham. I'm happy. Pearly, the sponsors and foreigners control the election and candidates. Everyone wants money in their hand when they when you visit their house. Interesting. Call you on the air. How you doing? Are you there, caller? You're impatient, but call you on the air. How you doing?
How you doing, Pearly?
I good. What's up?
I don't know. Looks like the people more concerned about eating.
Graham, how are you, sir? How are you, Graham?
I'm still tall, smart, and handsome, but thanks for asking. Anything change, I'll let you know.
Tall, smart, and handsome. I can take two of the three. I can take which one.
So it looks like the people still want eat for one day instead of feast for the rest of their life.
Okay.
You understand what I'm saying?
I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
You can give a dog, you can give a man a fish or give him a fishing line and teach him how to fish.
Well, that's strange that you would want to have something to eat today, but not be concerned about feasting for the rest of your life.
And I have an issue with that. When I see people, you know, when you hear the rumors, and I'm not going to, when you hear the rumors, this T-shirt get $50, that one, and you spending your vote for $100 for 5 years, when you do math, that's $20 a year.
Well, that's basically what we've done to education. See, smart people don't vote for dumb leaders.
Okay.
So you have to make sure.
But Graham,
they may not be as smart as the leader.
I know you're smart. I almost say something that's not, but I can leave that right there.
Yeah, we both have to be politically correct and watch what we say on radio, and that's another shame, isn't it? But
I'm gonna whisper that in your ear.
Well, we need to fix the Bahamas.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. I agree with you.
And you have a good one, and that starts with energy security, eh?
That's so you can be Minister of Energy and Security?
Well, I mean, I'd like to fill up my car for $2.
I hear you. Me too.
On Venezuelan fuel, that's $12 a gallon, you know?
Okay, gotcha. All right, brother. Thanks for calling, Graham. Graham and I have known each other for a long time, and we have some really good conversations personally. Love him to death. Do you think Pike will be a campaign donor in this upcoming general election? You're trying to cause me to say something I'm supposed to say. You have to buy the vote. You know, and the problem with Bahamas is that we run towards the gunshots. Personally, when I see or hear gunshots, I try to run opposite way. Meanwhile, the crowd running to not Pearly. If I hear something, I duck and down. You know, When I say you need money to run an election, I'm not talking about buying votes, you know. I'm not talking, and I can say this, and we can close out on this right now, Mr. Producer. I'm not talking about buying votes. I'm talking about literally just managing a campaign, your campaign headquarters, cars to go around with, food for your staff, snacks, paper to write on, computers, electricity, cable, your platform written on a piece of paper or a booklet, your manifesto or your R plan, everything, door hangers to hang out. You'll be surprised what it costs just to basically run a general election. And I ain't talking about giving nobody no money, you know. I'm talking about just running it generally. You take this last caller. Can we? Call you on there. How you doing?
Curly.
Hey. You got 30 seconds.
I mean, you're putting all those scenarios, you know, where you can need money for this and that. So you shouldn't pursue representing your country or being interested in running for your country because those are the hardships you're going to encounter.
No, I didn't say that. I said,
that's the implication, though. Like, you know,
no, I'm saying if you don't have the money, why do it if you don't have it? Why do it if you don't have the backing?
Well, because you never know in life what can happen, you know. You have people out there that are just listening, like you say, for the plan, I guess, you know, and a reasonable and sensible plan. You have people with resources.
Fair enough.
You know?
Yes, you do. You do have people with resources, and the question is, who do the people with the resources want to give their money to?
But really, you know what I'm hearing? Like, you know, like I think that when people come forward and they try to do something, right? You hear all of these, no, but you can't. It's like going to the bank, right?
Yes.
You know what you want to do? You want to get money for an investment, and they're telling you every way or which way you can't qualify, rather than say, well, listen,
this is what you need.
What you could do.
Yes,
right?
I agree. I agree.
Well, I don't like the defeatist. I'm not that kind. I guess, you know,
I'm
judging people by my standards. But, you know, it's like a defeatist, you know. And so young people, you see, we have to be careful, you know, what we put out there. Because, you know, we work hard as parents and grandparents to send our children off.
I agree.
To qualify. And you present this, but it is difficult. Don't ever try to represent your country because it's difficult, you know.
You mash me up on that. I get mashed up on the last call. No problem. Thank you, darling. Hey, I enjoyed these 3 days with you. Look forward to being back with you again sometime. Tomorrow I'm on Talking Heads at 4 o'clock. I'll see you in the sports section later. This has been Pearly on Z Live, filling in for Zhivargo Laing these 3 days on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Thank you so much for the calls, for the texts, for the encouragement, and for the bashing. I appreciate it all. Take care and have yourself a great, great afternoon.